It's your boy Splashy here. I think I've adapted the name 2K Woes because I've been coming up with a lot of stuff. I have obtained a 2K23 copy and I have seen the gameplay. Matter of fact, let's get straight into it. So I'm gonna be going through all of my tweets and giving like just a quick little fair explanation on it while showing, of course, some good Next Maker gameplay from Community Day, because I'm pretty sure if I show any gameplay, it's gonna get flagged or I'm gonna get a strike instantly. And you know, I'm not trying to be on 2K bad side, especially on YouTube with how good content creation will be this year. So I'm just gonna go through my tweets basically with gameplay in the background and talk on it as much as I can just to answer a little bit more questions about everything. So boom, one of my first tweets were, when you run out of adrenaline boosts on defense, you can still reach and or jump. So you have 3 adrenaline boosts on offense and you have 3 adrenaline boosts on defense. On defense, let's say I spam 3 reaches or spam 3 jumps right away, it doesn't mean you can't reach or jump anymore, but it does mean the more you reach or jump now, your stamina goes down quicker on defense and everything seems slower. I tested if you can still get a steal or block while your adrenaline boost is going, and you can, but it's a lot harder. So say you run out of adrenaline boost and you blitz, or whatever you guys call it, bump steal, or you reach out of passing lane when you're baiting, the ball might go right through your hands without having an adrenaline boost. So that's the first tweet, of course. Next we have, I was on for probably 5 hours when I made the tweet, but I was on for an insurmountable amount of time. I probably haven't even slept. And to date, on Superstar, I've seen 2 whites drop. On Semi-Pro, I've seen 6 whites drop. And yes, I've counted. And on Hall of Fame, I still have not seen a white drop. Even free throws are missing on Hall of Fame right now. So the skill gap that everybody is crying for, it's looking like we finally got it. From the player builder that I've seen from all the Next Makers, shout out to every single Next Maker. I hope you enjoy your journey and you do everything you're supposed to do. It's looking like they put you on that pedestal for a reason, so make sure you don't fall off of it. And make sure you honor everything you got to do. Y'all doing real good with the embargo. Keep it up for sure. From the player build, it's looking like you can't make like 4 things you specialize in the builder anymore. So like last year, we had 5 TMPGs with Hoff Clamps, Hoff Interceptor, Hoff Limitless, Hoff Quick First Step, Hoff Unpluckable, and Quick Drops. Now, and then we also had like shooting guards, guarding the wing, who were sharps, also PGs, also pure lockdowns, like none of that. It looks like you more have to specialize in 2 or 3 2 or 3 actual stat categories, whether it be shooting, defense, slashing, etc. And you're gonna have to pick your poison. Also, if you put a stat at 99, you are almost hindering your build. So you need to figure out what your threshold cap will be for most statistics. I'm saying around 92 for most is gonna get you by without taking everything. If I was to compare shooting any game, if you would like to try to compare this game to 21 Current, I wouldn't compare this game to 21 Current. I think 21 Current's game was a lot harder to shoot. This game, it's the green window is close to 21 Next Gen 2K20, but no whites drop. So that's really where the shooting skill gap comes in. I wouldn't say it's hard to shoot. I think it's fairly easy to time a jump shot. The green window seems very enlarged, but if you don't touch that green window, you miss every single time. Mashing, for people want to know if mashing was fixed. Honestly, if you have your timing on, so with your timing off, it looks like anything over around the 18% isn't going in consistently. 15% maybe, it's not going in consistently. With your timing on, I compare it to 21 Next Gen. If you remember when you used to have Sharp Badge and you could shoot any contested shot, or 21 Current with Steady Shooter, you could shoot any jump shot if you knew how to time it. Like when you have badge, mashing, like slashing, period, doesn't matter what the contest says. I've tested it with Giannis, I've tested it with LeBron, I've tested it with Kareem, I've tested it with centers. If you play the Jordan Challenge, Patrick Ewing gonna make sure he show you. You can green any contest in the paint if you learn how to time it. So when Wang was talking about skill gap to time and shots, if you learn how to time your layups, you can go up with anything. As of right now, the Scottie Pippen behind the back is no longer in the game. It looks like they either transformed it into another animation that either we don't have unlocked yet, or you better put on Jordan or Steph Curry. Also, difference in this game is if you're standing at Limitless, you can green most of the shots, but if you white, you will be airballing. So be prepared to see a lot of shots airballing. I'm not even talking about lates and earlies. I'm talking about slightly early, slightly late air balls. Fades are looking like they're still the same. It's looking like Trey Fade is going to be the best fade on the game. Once again, Stephen Curry Fade is probably going to be second. Normal will most likely be third. So you run with that as much as you will. Very easy to fade because the green window seems more enlarged on a fade than it is a regular shot. I would compare it to 21 Next Gen pre-patch 1. As of right now, if I would say, is the game catered more towards defenders than dribble heads, I would say defenders, because all the dribbling, even all the clips that you'll see, whether it's on TikTok or Twitter or from Next Makers, it looks real cute when you're dribbling in place right now. But when you put a defender, and yes, I have tested with another user, when you dribble in front of another person, like with Steph and Kawhi is guarding you, or Paul George guarding you, and you got Kyrie, or Giannis is on you, or LeBron is on you, or even a lower tier defender like Marcus Smart is guarding you. Well, not lower tier, but you know what I mean. They can easily keep up with you, like, while moving laterally, while you're doing all your hot sauce stuff. So you need to dribble to look to score. For all the people who want to know if Luka's base is officially dead, Luka's base is comparable to what it was on current gen 22, to where, like, he wasn't that OP. The base wasn't that OP on current gen, but on next gen, it was the best base we've ever seen. It's like they slowed it down by, like, a whole 2 seconds, and the release point is really, really different. The game as a whole is catered towards the better players at the moment. I think casuals will have a tough time with this game if the difficulty is on anything of Superstar to Hall of Fame. But I doubt Park is going to be on Superstar and Hall of Fame, so take what you will. And make sure with everything I'm saying, this is just off what I tested. A hot fix can drop, and most of the stuff I'm saying can be fixed when the real gameplay comes out. A lot of stuff can change. Difficulties might be smacked, they might hot fix and touch shooting or touch dribbling or touch stamina. You never know. This is just everything that I've tested with the game for sure as of right now. But I do think casuals, especially if you are a type who like loads up micro on Hall of Fame, I think you're in for a crazy day. I checked every single shot from the thresholds because there are new thresholds now. I think you need a higher three to obviously obtain certain guard shots or certain wing shots, but 6'4 and under, get a specific amount of releases. 6'5 and up, get a specific amount of releases. Once you touch 6'10 or 6'11, I don't know if it was weight or if it was height, you start to lose jump shots, like wings jump shots, and only be able to put on big men jump shots. I'm pretty sure animation glitch will come out, so we'll be fine. But there is no base three. I looked at every single shot with a large amount of people. There is no set shot 25. There are a few shots that are close to set shot 25, but it's not as OP as to what 25 would be. And for 98, of course, it's Dwayne Wade and Patty Mills, but they both look like crazy slowed down versus a 98. You still want Exum. Exum is still in the game for 6'5 and up. Ray Allen is still in the game for 6'5 and up. And a couple other like famous shots that people were using, such as Rudy Gay and other things of that nature. So you can do with that as you will. But I looked at every single shot, and no, I could not find those bases anywhere. They basically added every single NBA player you can think of and gave him a jump shot. The threshold when I was shooting on Hall of Fame seemed like it was around 78. When I put my three-pointer to 70, I had a stretch where I was hitting a large amount of shots, but the larger sample size I shot, I started missing. I would say like 78 was where, like, consistently out the corner, I was hitting probably 20 out of 20, 30 out of 30, 28 out of 30, 26 out of 30. When I was at 70 and I shot 30 shots, looking at my spreadsheet right now, I was more like 20 out of 30 one time. That was my best run, and it was like 15 out of 30, 18 out of 30, 17 out of 30. So if you can time your shot, you'll be just fine. But if you can't time your shot, like, don't expect to go in. Even if you have a 99-3, you're standing in the corner. As of right now, I was obviously shooting on Hall of Fame. For everything I'm telling you, it was tested on Hall of Fame. So obviously it's going to be different when the real game drops, but no whites were dropping. Fast break defense for sim players or my team players, quick match players, play now players, whatever, my GM players, my online franchise making players, like, fast break defense is fixed and they don't drop to the paint off the rebound anymore. So you can have to not worry about giving up a three every single time the fast break starts. But the transition take foul, which is the new foul that got implemented, the take two that got implemented into the real NBA. If a player off the rebound puts the ball on the ground and one player on his team is past half court, so let's say I'm the Jazz and you're the Hornets. Hornets shoot a shot, I'm the Jazz, I get the rebound, I put the ball on the ground, and my point guard is past the half court line, and you foul me, whether it's an intentional foul, a reach-in foul, a bump foul when you know you try to go out of bounds and it gives you a personal foul, that's a transition take foul. You get to shoot a free throw, shot clock resets, and you get the ball back backcourt, not even in the half court. So the only counter I saw was you need to foul off rebound before the ball goes on the ground instantly. As of right now, I think player build still runs over stats. If y'all know what I'm talking about, on 22, it seemed like player build, like a bigger player or more weight, actually was better than statistics. But in order, I think it goes badges, player build, stats. And the reason I say badges, a lot of the badges on Hoff, you can tell they're on Hoff when they're on Hoff. But with the way the player builder looks, I don't think we're going to be getting that many badges on Hoff neither. So that's just that. Plucks in the paint are the best they've ever been. I don't know if you guys played League Build or even know about the 2K League Build, but Power Forwards were able to strip centers at a high rate. I would compare this probably to 2K17 and 2K19. When you get the ball, you almost have to, I don't know if you have to press L2 or what, I really almost couldn't find a counter. If you reach, I had Kawhi versus Giannis. Giannis was getting the offensive rebound, and while I was testing Kawhi, Kawhi was taking the ball out of his hand every single play. Like, it's almost before you even finish grabbing the rebound, it can take the ball out of your hand. So I don't have a counter to Plucks in the paint at the moment. It's almost like they put you into a new animation, but Bully can just push them fully out the way. So yeah, the quick stops on the game as of right now, it's very hard to do unless you do the current gen 21 quick stop, to where you would push your right stick east west, or the 2K20 quick stop where you push it like down diagonal left or right. So other than that, I mean, the quick stop that we usually do where you just fully pull out of an animation where you're doing a move, like I speed boost right and just shoot off of it, it's not consistent because all of the speed bursts aren't consistent at the moment, but I'm pretty sure that changes when the hotfix drops. Rebound animations, from what I tested, are flying left, right, short. It doesn't look like there's any algorithm to figuring out. Usually you can memorize where rebounds go. Like if you shoot a 50, it's gonna go short. If you shoot a 30 from far, it's gonna go hard. If you shoot from the right corner and shoot a good release and you miss, it's gonna go middle. Like usually you can memorize the animations, but I couldn't really memorize them. It looks like they're still like flying every which way, but centers with good position will be able to grab everything off the rim because the rebound animations were looking crazy when I was testing Giannis jumping and Joel Embiid jumping. And I had power forwards guarding, like I put like a Draymond on Giannis, and Draymond couldn't get the rebound over Giannis when Giannis had positioning. Giannis was worming him every time, etc., etc. Jump shot wise, I think there will be jump shots that, like, obviously the better players or higher content creators use, but there are at least 10 to 15 shots. Bases, and I'm talking about bases. Uppers you can almost put on anything you want. Obviously there are better ones than others, but bases is about 10 to 15 viable bases I saw for 6'4 and under, and for 6'5 and up I saw probably 12 viable bases. So it looks like you'll be able to spread out whatever shots you're comfortable with and get doing what you need to do. This game reminds me of 2K19, where before the manual contest patch, which was around like patch 3, if you're not manually contesting, and it's the same thing as slashing, where I said if you can time a contested shot, you can slash at will. I'm not going to say it's as gassed as mismatch was pre-patch 1 last year, but when I had Stephen Curry and I was shooting in Giannis's mid, and I had Giannis playing for a ghost, which is a ghost contest. If you don't know what a ghost contest is, it's when you don't play real D and you sit back a little bit further than being right on their body shading them, and you would get like a 12 or like a 14 last year, or like a 10 last year, which was pretty high. So that's that. If you don't manually contest, I think they can mid you every time, because I was midding Giannis, midding, and you know what midding is. I was doing emotes in his face while his hand wasn't up, but when he jumped, it was like a 70 every single time. So it's looking like you can green if they just stand there. So that's good for stretches, that's good for point guards and sharps coming off the screen as well. Locks, if you put your right stick up, they're not greening anything, so that's your counter. Post fades are back, and the reason I think post fades are back is because I tested it with a 66 post fade, a 60 post fade, and a 72 post fade. Then I put it on 99. When I put it on 99 on Hall of Fame, I didn't miss a post fade with Giannis. And then when I was testing it with my player, I made his post fade was 66. I win the game on Hall of Fame and put on a good post fade, and I would knock down every single one with the contest. If you figure out which side, but you need to make sure you figure out which shoulder you're fading off of and not just fade into their body every play, you can green almost every single time with post fades right now. But it's because the green window seems enlarged anywhere inside of the three-point line, so that might be why. You can spam dribble as much as you want. in place. I've had half handles for days. The stamina actually drains faster than the adrenaline boost, so don't think you can just sit there and triple misdirection into the Asta slide, into the triple spin cancel, into the Hezzy momentum push cross. Like, you're dead. Maybe when we get Gatorade, it'll be better, but the stamina, unless they touch it, is looking very tough for guards. If y'all can hear my dog barking, I'm sorry. It's probably somebody outside, probably the feds at the door, and they ready to get me off from telling y'all about this game. Full bars are now out of the game. If you didn't know what a full bar was, even if you turn on your meter, it was tested by 2K Labs, was tested by everybody. If you shoot perfect every single time, 15 times last year, or 21 or 20, you would get a full bar animation. And it was when you keep your hand in the air and you have a follow through. And when you have a follow through, it seems like, you know, you think you missed, but that was really the game's RNG saying you hit the green window, but they don't think you hit the perfect green window. And you'll get the same animation as you did when you green. And usually people will say I'm getting cheated, but you get a full bar animation on earlies, lates, everything. So there are no more full bar animations. It looks like you either have to say, hey, I missed it, or hey, I greened it. Like, that's just that. Locks bumping as a whole takes like 10 to 15% of their stam. If you get a good initial bump, the higher your strength, I think the more stam you take from them when you bump them. So if a guard's getting bumped, you might want to get a reset for sure. Screens are hitting probably closest to 17 and 19. I'm not going to say it's as gassed as they fall on the ground, but the screens 100% were clipping Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant. Everybody I was putting on ball was getting clipped by screens, by even guards. Like, I was setting screens with like Klay Thompson and they were getting clipped every time. Fades are 100% back. I think I already said that one, but I made a couple tweets about that. You can Trey fade, you can Steph Curry fade. The green window seems very big. Like, when you learn how to time your shot, you're probably not going to miss, but it's to the point where if you don't green it and you shoot from too deep, you're going to probably break your foot and air ball. I don't know if y'all know the animation I'm talking about where you lean forward, it looks like you break your foot. It's very easy to green, especially from the midi. Like, so shot creators might be back and better than they ever have been. Like, inside of the three-point line, I think the green window is like crazy big. Like, so that's just that. I tested having play takeover. The adrenaline boost isn't instant, and it isn't like you can spam a little bit more. Your stamina, like your real stamina bar, you can dribble a lot more, but the adrenaline boost that comes back probably, let's say it comes back 5 seconds if you wait for your adrenaline boost to come back. It comes back probably in like 2.5-3 seconds when you got playmaking badge. Dunking is very OP if you learn how to use the dunk meter to your advantage, but I think you got to do like right stick up, right stick down, right stick right, right stick left, press triangle, press square, and then do a GTA cheat code to activate it. But if you learn how to activate it, I'm pretty sure I saw every single one I was doing dropping every single time. Chase downs are nowhere near as good as they were in 2K22, so it doesn't look like we'll need quick drops for every single take we do this year. You probably can put on some good rim grazes or just a good athletic two-hand and be just fine. You can still get chase downs, but last year you could let somebody go drive to the paint and stand at half court, then go meet him and you block it off backboard every play unless you got on quick drop. So multiple dunk packages should finally be good this year. When I was testing Euro steps and hop steps with Giannis and LeBron James, I tested it with like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, I tested it with like Shaq. With Bully, it almost looks like it pushes them off you when you get ready to go off, especially if you have a higher Bully than they have Anchor. But other than that, I wouldn't say it's as gassed as Fancy Footwork was, but you get a little bit of stuns, and sometimes it doesn't let them react on time. It gives them sometimes a little mini ankle breaker animation. So Euro stepping and hop stepping should have a skill gap if somebody figures out how to do that. In order of importance, speed has destroyed strength every single year. I think strength will be needed, especially to guard up. One, to not get clipped by screens, I think strength will be mattered more than speed. Speed is good, but speed is always good. And it's usually if he's faster than me, I can't stop him. Strength for bumps, for using bully, for worm animations, for rebound animations, etc. I think strength is going to mean a lot. From what I say, in order of importance of what builds I think will impact the most on the court, no matter what game mode you play, I think if you have a lockdown, I think lockdown 100%. If you have a god tier lockdown, I think you will rarely lose. No matter, even if you have a decent point guard or a god tier point guard, I think the lockdown will always outshine them with the way offense is looking right now. Obviously, somebody's going to figure somebody out, the BPs, the Fannas, etc. Like, they're going to figure something out when, you know, the game fully drops. But as of right now, it's looking like lockdowns are going to be the main person doing their thing. Centers, if you learn how to time the layups, and you can make anything in the paint, especially with Masher Gold, I didn't. Masher Hoff was crazy if you could time it. Like, I was hitting 36s, 46s, 56s, 66s on Hall of Fame with Giannis when I put his Masher on Hall of Fame. But when it was on gold, silver, like, you still can make them, but obviously you don't green them at the rate. I think centers will be second because the rebounding animations are amazing, and it doesn't look like they can just, you know, get pushed to the side by power forwards. Sharps will be third because shooting from deep will be a skill gap that only sharps will most likely be able to do. Power forwards are looking like they are going to be better than ever because lanes still look just as good as they were. And then I think PG's our last. I think PG's the hardest position coming into this game. PG hasn't been the hardest position on past games. Like, on 22, I don't think PG was the hardest position because you could just walk around D-Rose and back and forth shooting with set shot. Speed glitch on 21, so PG wasn't hard. 20, I think pre-behind the back, it wasn't that hard. But then I think post-behind the back, it was pretty hard. 19, PG was god-tier hard until dribble glitch came out. 18, PG was hard in the beginning, but then it became the easiest 2K you've ever seen. 17, 16, 15, y'all already know. The blitzes got slowed down a lot. If you look the blitz a lot, it's looking like it'll throw you out the player. Your player is just going to take a second to move again. So, like, make sure when you set up your blitz or your bump steal that you actually setting it up the way it should be. I do think that this game is going to be harder than 21 Currington as a whole, even though I think 21 Currington shooting was harder. And the reason I say that is because 21 Currington, even though the shooting was hard, we had the speed glitch to get us anywhere we needed to go, and it lasted us all year. So if you think hard is fun, I think you'll enjoy this game. But we'll see if this game lasts as hard as it is. Stretches can shoot over smaller players. I was testing it at the size of 6'8", and then I was testing it at the size of 7 foot. Then I tested at the size of 6'6 and put a 6'3. And then on 7 foot, I put a 6'5 on them. 6'8, I had a 6'5 on them. If you are not manually contesting, the contest will say like 20 or 19 or 15, but you can green it if you learn the timing, especially if you put on the badge guard up. As of right now, I think big guards are better than small guards. My definition of a big guard, because I come from Pro-Am, is like 6'3", 6'4". That's what I consider a big guard, because obviously we're not coming in Pro-Am with a 6'9 point guard, because it just doesn't work like that. That's just not what the competitive aspect does. But usually smaller guards were better. Like last year with the 5'10", small guards were faster, so therefore small guards were better. But this year it looks like you need to create separation off your steps. So I think big guards are going to create more separation in their actual dribbling, like, moves and their dribble sigs, compared to when I tested my 5'10", it took him a lot longer to get from left wing to right wing, even though he was doing more moves quicker. But the big guard, when I was 6'4", 6'5", was getting from the left wing to right wing a lot quicker. So you need to create separation right now, because all that dribbling stuff is cute till it's somebody in front of you. Alley-oops, like, if you remember, since they added the timing for the lobs on Next Gen 22, lobs are probably the worst they've ever been. Standing lobs look like they'll work, but other than that, alley-oops are just done for. This is probably the best thing that I think was added. There is a new setting called shot timing release time preferred. Like, it's, and the setting is your preference. When I say it's your preference, so the reason I think this is good, I'm gonna get to that in a minute, it's your preference. So say I'm shooting with Giannis's shot and I think it's too slow, I can put my release point on early or very early. Early is probably gonna be like, I would say early would be like 3/4. So like, the thing that most people would be comfortable on is putting their release time in on early. Very early would be for the people who want to skill gap the shooting. But let's say I have Giannis's shot, and then I put very early on it. My green window cue is going to be quicker than his regular shot. So if I let's say I'm heavy-handed and I like releasing my shots later, you can put it on late, and you can shoot the shots slower because that's what you would like to do. But say you like to release your shots earlier, and which is, it's probably, and from what it seems like, it's easier to shoot contested shots when it's on very early, because it feels like it's on like 5 out of 4. You can make your green window go to a different aspect for your preferred shot. And I think this is big for people who play on other servers. So let's say like Ticino plays on other servers and comes to play on West server, and he's wild delay. I think if he puts his preferred shot timing, or West server people when they go to play East, because you know West server people have had it bad for like 5 to 6 2Ks, You can put your preferred shot on very early. So then when you go to East, whether you're delayed or not, your release timing is still the same as it was on West. Once again, if you can hear my dog, I'm very sorry. My dog is barking right now, so I hope that doesn't affect, you know, everything I'm telling you. But if you put your release timing on very early and you're like a West server player, you're like on separate over the continent like servers, I'm pretty sure that you can still have the same release time that you're used to, even while you're delayed. So let's say, because usually you will go from west server to east server, and your shot feels slower or quicker when you go to an opposite server because you actually feel delayed. Even though you're delayed, you can still release the timing for what you're used to, and you'll be fine. So that's why I think that's probably one of the biggest things as of right now that I'm seeing that was added. So I think that'll be liked by a lot of people, especially West server and cross-continent server people when they go play on US servers, etc., etc. So the preferred shot time and release time, I think that's going to be one of the better things. Other than that, that's almost everything. We're almost done here. Getting ready to wrap it up with the last few things I was talking about. Dexin is amazing. I'm not going to say it's not what it was when you were VVing or what do you call it, BBing, etc. On 17, Dexin off the inbound. 17 is probably the best we're going to have. 19 is really close too. But off-ball movement, when I had a user guard me and we both player locked, it does still have the invisible force field if you try to dex too far. But if you don't have defense and you have slippery on, I think I had it on go when I was testing it, you can drag them every which way that you want to go, and then you can shoot the shot because they can't manually play your dex and manually put the foot and manually put their hand up. So I think Dexin would be one of the best it's been, especially I think it's a skill gap to it, though I don't think everybody will be able to do it to the extent that they were able to on 2K17, 18, and 19. So this is basically everything that I've tested on Hall of Fame as of right now. So if you tested something else and want to drop something in the comments, make sure you do. Make sure y'all leave a like, make sure y'all leave a comment, and make sure y'all subscribe. Content is going to be going crazy. They've been calling me the 2K Woes lately for everything that I'm giving people. And this gameplay that we are showing is actually from one of the next makers. So 2K, if you try to come flag me, this is from Community Day. I'm just talking over his gameplay. I'm not showing any of my gameplay yet, but when I am allowed to show gameplay, it's gonna be crazy, man. Trust me. So make sure y'all stop by the Twitch, especially I stream all the time, Splashy. Make sure y'all sub. Follow me on Twitter @Splash Edition. I love every single one of y'all. I'll make sure we good this game. Trust me. Peace.